Hello students, now let us see the performance of the experiment to prepare and submit non-staining iodine ointment with methyl salicylate. So the requirement for this experiment is we are going to require a weighing balance, beaker, glass mortar and pestle, stoppered iodine flask, water bath, tripod stand, china dish, spatula and glass rod, etc. We also require, in chemicals, we are going to require iodine, soft paraffin, methyl salicylate, arachis oil, purified water, etc. So now let us see the principle of this experiment. The fats and the oils, okay, which are obtained from the animal or plant sources, they contain unsaturated fatty acids or their esters. So here the iodine, in this experiment, we are using iodine. Okay, so this iodine, it combines with the double bonds and thus free iodine is not available. Okay, so in non-staining iodine ointment, BBC, it contains 5% of iodine, which we are going to mix with the base of yellow soft paraffin and arachis oil. And also it contains 5% of methyl salicylate along with the iodine, right? So this type of iodine, it is an example of ointment containing combined iodine and it is prepared by chemical reaction. So the fixed oil, as we have seen, and many of the fats, they contain, which are obtained from animal and vegetable sources, they contain unsaturated constituents, which are fatty acid containing double and the triple bond linkage. So as we are going to use here arachis oil, it contains fatty acid such as oleic acid. So in this preparation, the iodine, it gets combined with the double bonds, okay, of these acids which are present in arachis oil, and thus iodine, it does not remain available in the free form. Okay, so it does not leave staining. Iodine, it has got highly staining properties, as iodine is not free. Okay, there occurs no staining. Okay, so when you rub it against your skin, this ointment, it does not stain, and hence it is called as non-staining. So if you see here, this is the acid which contains the double bond, and here you have, and this acid is present in the arachis oil, right? This is oleic acid. So with this oleic acid, the iodine, it is going to get reacted, and it will form this diiodostearic acid. Okay, so here in this process, iodine is used as counter irritant. Okay, and methyl salicylate, it act as anti-inflammatory. So arachis oil, it act as source of unsaturated fatty acid, and also it might contain sufficient unsaturated linkage to make the complex with iodine. Okay, and a yellow soft paraffin, it act as the ointment base. Okay, so as I told you already, no free iodine is available. This ointment, it is a dark or greenish black in color. So it does not leave any stain when it is rubbed on the skin. Now we will see the preparation of this ointment. Now we are going to see how the experiment of preparation and submission of non-staining iodine ointment with methyl salicylate is performed. Okay. Now today we are going to prepare this methyl salicylate ointment, non-staining iodine ointment with methyl salicylate, 20 grams. Okay. So in this, as we have seen in the principle, that this iodine is going to react with the double bond which is present into this arachis oil, and due to that the iodine is going to be non-staining. Okay, so the formula for this is iodine, we are going to take 5 grams, arachis oil 15 ml, yellow soft paraffin 100 grams and methyl salicylate 5 ml. Okay, so this is the basic formula. Now this formula is provided for 125 grams of iodine ointment. We have to prepare 20 grams. Okay, so now we will see the role of each ingredient. So here iodine, it acts as counter irritant. Whereas arachis oil, it is used for reaction between iodine and its double bond, which renders the iodine
non-stain. Okay, then yellow soft paraffin, it is our base. Okay, whereas this methyl salicylate, it acts as anti-inflammatory. As we have seen in the principle, iodine, it is highly staining. If you have seen iodine, well, you will see during the performance of this experiment, iodine is somewhat dark purple to blackish in color. Okay, so if we use iodine like that, then it is staining. When you apply this ointment, okay, it will give you a blackish stain on your body surface. Okay, so we don't want that. Hence, we want to use iodine, but we don't want its staining property, right? So we are going to bring about a reaction between iodine and the double and triple bonds which are present in the arachizoid. Okay, so due to that, this iodine, it reacts with those double bonds and it becomes completely colorless. Okay, so it retains its property, its action of counter irritant, but it does not retain its color. Okay, so it becomes non-staining. Hence the name is non-staining iodine ointment, right? Now we are going to add methyl salicylate. Methyl salicylate, it acts as anti-inflammatory, and yellow soft paraffin, it is the base. Okay, so the general procedure of this formulation is that first we will allow the reaction to take place between iodine and the arachizoid. Okay, so we are going to heat the mixture of this iodine and arachizoid oil in a stoppered flask. Okay, now why stoppered flask? Because when we heat iodine, it can vaporize directly. Okay, and we don't want losses of our iodine which we are going to include in our formulation. To avoid those losses, we are going to stopper the iodine, right? Also, one thing which you have to keep in mind is iodine, it is corrosive with metals and it is highly staining. So we are not going to use spatula for measuring iodine, but we are going to use a plastic spoon. Okay, also iodine, it is available in the form of crystals, so we are going to use a glass mortar to crush that iodine. Okay, if you go for regular your porcelain mortar and pestle, then it gets stained completely. Okay, so we don't want that. So these are the two precautions which we have to take in case of using iodine or handling iodine, right? So now we are going to allow the reaction to take place between iodine and arachizoid by heating this mixture at 50 degree Celsius in a stoppered flask on water bath, right? So in between you have to check this mixture, reaction mixture, for staining property. You are going to heat it until there occurs no staining on the skin of iodine. Okay, or we can say you have to heat it till the blackish color, it gets transferred into greenish color, right? So till that time we are going to heat it. Then separately we will melt this yellow soft paraffin, and to this yellow soft paraffin we will add this ingredient. Okay, so we will mix it up, and after that, as the reaction mixture, it will start to cool down. So when it comes below 30 degrees Celsius, this temperature of this mixture, it falls below 30, at that time we are going to add methyl salicylate. Okay, methyl salicylate, it is highly volatile. Okay, if you add it in the hot mixture, it will get vaporized and it will be lost into the atmosphere. It won't be available into your formulation. Okay, so to avoid that, we are going to add it after the temperature of this mixture, it falls below 30 degrees. Then we will simply add methyl salicylate and we will dispense it in our container. Okay, now let us see the procedure. So now let us see. First, we have measured methyl salicylate. Then we have taken arachizoid. Then we have taken iodine. Then yellow soft paraffin, right? So this is our glass mortar and pestle, and into this we will crush this iodine crystals. Why do you have to crush this iodine crystal? Because to increase the rate of reaction, okay, you are going to crush it. If you use this crushed iodine, then the reaction will occur fastly. So we are going to increase the rate of the reaction, right? So now it is very finely crushed, as you can see here. Now we are going to take this iodine flask and into it we are going to first add the arachis oil. Into this we are going to add the crushed iodine. Added all the iodine. We will stopper this flask and we are going to mix it well. Okay. Now we will put this on a heating water bath and we will wait until this solution it becomes greenish in color or it becomes non-steaming, right? So in between you have to mix, just shake this arachis oil and iodine mixture. Okay, so that the reaction occurs uniformly. You have to shake it in between. Also using a thermometer, we are going to monitor the temperature of this water bath. It is a very long process. Okay, the reaction, it takes a very long time to complete. It almost requires more than half an hour, 45 minutes almost, for this mixture to become non-steaming. Now as you can see, after heating it for a long time, the color has changed a little. Okay, so you have to keep on shaking and you have to keep on heating this material. Now once we will check the staining property, so what you have to do, you have to remove this lid, okay. You have to take a glass rod and you just have to dip it and take out a very small amount of it and put it on your skin, okay, over here, right. Now once you have put it here, you have to just spread it. Okay, still it is giving you the stain. Okay, that means our reaction, it has not completed and we will have to heat it for some more time. Now after so much of heating, if you observe here, the color has started to become greenish. Okay, so now again we will perform the staining technique. We will take out the lid. We will take a very small drop of this mixture. And you have to be very careful because it is very hot, so just don't directly put the drop on your skin, okay. Just put a slight drop, okay? And then check it for staining, okay. If you observe here, it is not staining that much, okay. I'll take some more. Look, now it is staining less, so we will heat it for some 5 to 10 minutes more and then we will get a complete stainless mixture. Now this iodine reaction is complete. You can see the green color and also it is now completely non-staining. Okay, now we will check it for its staining property. On rubbing it, it becomes non-staining. Okay, so now we will take it out, we will put it aside, and then we will melt this yellow soft paraffin. Again, you have to use the water bath and you have to mix it. Now see, it has completely melted. Okay, now we will remove this from the flame and we will put it aside for 2 minutes. Now as you can see here, this it has completely melted already. Now we will pour this molten mass into the iodine mixture. We are going to shake it thoroughly so that iodine and this yellow soft paraffin, it mixes well. Now again we will take out this into the china dish. As you can see here now, all the iodine, it has got mixed up with the liquid yellow soft paraffin. Now we will allow it to solidify. We will shake it so that it will get cooled down. We will see the temperature in between. And after that, after it is cooled a little bit, we are going to add methyl salicylate into it. Now as you can see, the temperature has reduced, okay, and it has started to solidify. So we will still cool it, and after that we will add the methyl salicylate. So now as it has cooled, so we are going to add methyl salicylate into it. We will still cool it further. You have to mix it well so that the methyl salicylate gets dispersed evenly into all the formulation. So now as you can see, it has solidified completely. So we will just test it. We will take a small amount of this ointment and we will apply it on our skin. Okay, now as you can see here, it is not at all staining, right? So the ointment is formulated very well. Okay, and it smells just exactly similar to the Iodex, which we get in the market. That odor it gets due to the methyl salicylate, right? Now we have taken this amber colored bottle. Every time you have to keep in mind that iodine, it has to be stored in amber colored containers only. As this is a ointment, we are going to fill it in wide mouth container. Okay, so this is amber colored wide mouth container and we will fill it. So we have completely filled our container with the ointment. And now as you can see here, we have placed the label. So first you are going to write the name of the formulation, that is non-staining iodine ointment with methyl salicylate, and here you are going to write the quantity. We have prepared 20 grams, okay? So now first you will write the formula. Iodine we have taken 1 gram, arachis oil we have taken 3 grams, then yellow soft paraffin 15 grams, methyl salicylate 1 gram, okay? So this total becomes 20. Then the category of this ointment, it act as anti-inflammatory. Storage is store in well, store in cool and dry place. Then we have written the manufacturing date, expiry date, manufacturing license number, batch number, and direction, which is given by the physician. So the direction for this ointment is that you have to apply on affected area as directed by the physician. And lastly, we will write the label, that is for external use only. And here at the bottom, you have to write the name of the institute. Okay. So now this formulation is complete.
Now, after formulation, we can say the category of this formulation is anti-inflammatory. Storage is you have to store it in amber colored container and you have to place it in cool and dry space. The direction of application is you have to apply it on the affected area as per directions of the physician. And in the label, you have to explain that it is for external use only. Okay. So now if we see the label, so it is non-staining iodine ointment with methyl salicylate 20 grams. The formula which we have used, iodine 1 gram, arachis oil 3 grams, soft paraffin 15 gram, methyl salicylate 1 gram. Its category is anti-inflammatory, storage is store in amber colored container in cool and dry place. Then manufacturing date, expiry date, manufacturing license number, batch number and direction. Okay, so you have to apply it on affected areas per the direction of the physician and this label, that is for external use only. Okay, so in observation we are going to write that its appearance is smooth and it is blackish in color and it is non-staining soft paste. So in the result, we will tell that 20 grams of non-staining iodine ointment with methyl salicylate was prepared and submitted. So the most commonly asked question about this experiment are, you'll be asked to define ointment. Then you'll have to explain the principle of non-staining iodine ointment with methyl salicylate. So here you have to tell that iodine, okay, it is staining, okay, right? If you just use iodine, it is going to stain on your skin, okay? But when you make that iodine to react with any type of vegetable oil, okay, at that time the double and triple bonds which are present in that fats and oil, okay, that the iodine, it reacts with those unsaturated linkages and it gets incorporated to form the diiodo components, okay? And because of that, the iodine, it loses its staining property. Okay, so that you will have to explain in the principle. Then you will have to tell the category of non-staining iodine ointment with methyl salicylate. So its category is anti-inflammatory. Next question will most probably asked is, what is the labeling condition for the non-staining iodine ointment with methyl salicylate? So it is, you have to use it for, use it externally only. And lastly, it will be asked, it might be asked how to apply this ointment. So you have to say that it has to be applied on the affected area as per the direction of the physician. So this was all about the experiment of preparation and submission of non-staining iodine ointment with methyl salicylate. So thank you.